Would you like to know how to create a Twitter list on your Twitter account for your business? Stay tuned, that's today's Curly Marketer Tip. Hey, it's Philip here, the Curly Marketer. You're very welcome to today's Curly Marketer Tip. If you're a small business owner or an entrepreneur, do consider subscribing to the YouTube channel. Lots of tips and tricks to help you start using social media effectively for your business. Now, today I wanted to talk about Twitter lists. Now, what are these? Well, I think they're something that a lot of businesses fail to use effectively or don't use at all, and you're really missing out a trick when you're using Twitter within your social media. Effectively, a Twitter list is a special list that you can create of Twitter accounts, you know, businesses, people, individuals on Twitter that you don't have to follow, but that you can put them into specific designated Twitter lists that would allow you to then go to that list and see what those people are tweeting about. Now, who are some of these people that you could turn into lists? Well, your customers. You could create a private customer list and every morning go on and see what your customers are tweeting about. Are they tweeting about something that maybe you weren't aware of? Have they got some good news? It would allow you as a business to get involved maybe in a congratulation conversation. You could also create a private list of your competitors. What are they tweeting about? Are they tweeting about some industry news, new developments that you weren't aware of, that suddenly maybe you're behind the curve and you need to up your game? So once again, keeping an eye on your competitors from the Twitter point, having a Twitter list is very useful. You could also have an influencer Twitter list. If there are certain influential individuals or companies in your industry that you would like to try and create a relationship with, great to have a Twitter list of those people so you can see what they're posting and maybe retweet, reshare, comment, and start to build a relationship where you get to the point maybe where they share your content. Now, how do you create a Twitter list? Well, stay tuned. I'm going to show you very simply how you can do this. Okay, so this is how you create a Twitter list. See here on my profile, lists. Let's click on lists. And then up in the top right, you'll see like a little document with a plus sign. Click on that to create a new list. Now you can, if you want, you can add a bespoke personalized photo for your list. Some people like to do this, especially with public lists, where they may have other Twitter followers will actually subscribe to their list. But for the purpose of this video, I'm just going to leave that blank and we're just going to focus on private lists. I'm just going to go test list. Now, once again, if you were naming this your customer list, you might go, you know, top customer list and maybe a description. So if there was team members managing this, at least they'd understand what they had to put into this list. But obviously with something like your customers and maybe your competitors, you want to make it private. By making it private, it means that when you add people to the list, they won't be notified. And once again, this is quite relevant for your competitors because you wouldn't want your competitors to know that maybe you're adding them to a list. The next thing then is click next. And here you want to obviously start to maybe add people. Now I'm just going to look for my good friend Emer Duffy of Fit Social Media. Here's Emer. Now obviously we're following each other, but to add someone to a list, you don't have to follow them. You can literally see here, you can just go add. And you click done. Now obviously, when you click done, you can go back into the list and add more people. But the beauty of the Twitter list is that, let's just say this list was a list of my customers or my competitors. I can now just go into this list every morning and I can see in this case, what has Emer been tweeting. So as you can see, I can see that she has retweeted. This is a tweet she's put out about stories, another retweet, etc, etc. So I can now see what Emer is talking about. So if you apply the same logic to your competitors, you can go into your competitor list and just see what your competitors have been tweeting about, rather than trying to go into, if I just show you, say the main home feed up here, and be scrolling through, and there's thousands of tweets every second. So if I'm trying to find a particular tweet from me, a particular customer or competitor, I'm never going to find it. And that's the beauty of creating these Twitter lists.
So I hope you found today's Curly Marketer Tip useful.
Twitter lists. I think they are so undervalued, yet so potent for your Twitter marketing strategy. So definitely today, start to set up some private Twitter lists for yourself. Definitely start with maybe your customers and your competitors. It will allow you each morning to go in and just check those feeds rather than trying to delve into your home feed, which will be jam-packed with thousands of tweets and you'll never find anything. If you want to know more about me, do go to my website, thecurlymarketer.com. Do subscribe to the YouTube channel, and I will be back very soon with another Curly Marketer tip. Take care.